Well, I'm back from Michigan. It has been a minute since I've made videos like this, so now I'm here to get down to business. And I want to talk about something very important. But before I get into my sermon, I want to talk about what happened earlier on. Someone inboxed me on my public page, Leonard L. Mirrod's Voodoo Experience. And they were inquiring about what I thought about a screenshot they sent me of a YouTube spiritualist by the name of spiritualist by the name of Chondracardia or something of that nature. The picture had her advertising a package, a spiritual package. It had, I guess, a poppet in there, what some would call a voodoo doll, allegedly. It had sage in there. It had numerous items. I guess some resin of frankincense. And this person wanted my opinion of what did I think about it, you know? And me being objective, I told her that the items to someone not in the know is useless, but to someone who knows, it's useful. They can apply it. I told this person also, the power is not in a tool. The power is in your mind. So now, I'm going to commence to my sermon. When I say the power is in your mind, this is what I mean to say. When you're doing work, a lot of it comes from your experience. Someone can have the same items that you have, and they do not bear the same results that you do. You can give someone a candle and a bunch of oils, and you give someone experience the same candles with a bunch of oils, I guarantee you the person with experience can make something out of it. The novice that doesn't know will create a mess. It's like a homeowner versus a carpenter. You give the homeowner the power tools that an experienced carpenter has, and you give the experienced carpenter the same tools, and you tell them to build stairs. The homeowner will probably make a mess. The carpenter has to say, okay, I'm going to calculate my run, and I'm going to calculate, okay, I'm going to calculate my run times how much treads, and he's going to do his calculations to find out how much stairs, how many risers, at what, at what height, you know, should the risers be, and, you know, in correlation to the distance from the wall and the height, you know. So he's going to do all his calculations, then he's going to take his framing square, he's going to take his skill saw, and he's going to start cutting away. And he's going to build a set of stairs. Now, you go back to the homeowner, you'll see the homeowner taking a longer time. And not only that, the homeowner is cutting stairs with risers that are higher than one another, than each riser. One riser's at 7 inches, another riser's at 5 inches, another riser's at 4 inches. The homeowner creates a mess. Most of spiritual work is about wisdom. It's about knowing what to do. There's a lot of people out here that are complete imbeciles. They are imbeciles. They don't know what to do with what they have. And this is why most customers are always running to me. You know, they're coming to me from different spiritualists who has done work for them. See, there's a difference between being a wholesaler and a person that's applying the science. A wholesaler just sells products. The worker puts those products into practice. That worker knows how to mix the combinations up correctly, just like a recipe. They say in the South, certain grandmas have certain recipes to certain dishes that she keeps to herself and she don't show anybody. People be asking grandma, you know, how do you make this? How do you make that? You know, why does it taste so good? And she won't give up a recipe. See, the thing is, a person can copy what I do, but they'll never be able to duplicate it. You can imitate it, but you'll never be able to duplicate it. You can watch what I, you can take a picture of what you may see me post in some of my past Facebook posts, and you can try to imitate it, and you will not have the same results because there's a science behind what I do. And that science, that's what you have to pay for. You know, see, when I'm talking to clients, I'm giving them game. I'm giving them guidance. So when a customer comes to me, like I always said in the past, I don't care if it's a piece of wood. I don't care if it's a piece of paper. If it gets the job done, that's all that fucking matters. Because you wasn't able to do it on your own. Some people may complain about certain people selling certain things, you know, at high prices. I don't give a damn what the spiritualist is charging. If it gets the job done, that's all that fucking matters. Yeah, you can go buy this fucking oil with this person for $15, and you can go buy the oil from this person for $100 or $500. It's all about whether or not, here it goes. Let me just put it like this. Let me correct this. Someone's selling the same oil for $500. Now, the thing is, when you buy the oil for $500, will you be able to apply it? Yes, there's power in it. But will you be able to execute what you need to in order to get the results you desire? When you pay the premium, you're paying for the guidance. A gun in itself has the potential to bring harm. It has the potential to create peace. But it needs someone to pull the trigger. And someone, rather I say, I will just leave that thought as that. I'm not going to go too deep into that. But I think you guys understand what I'm trying to convey. The power, how can I say this? The person that puts things into emotion, or the executor, or the one that executes, is you. Too many people put power in things they see, and they forget the power dwells in them. When people say, Leona, ou fait bon travail, or you do good work, no, your faith made you well. I gave you the wisdom and you listened and you carried it out. You believed in what I told you to do. Your own actions made that reality come true. People underestimate their power all the time. Today, I've come to make you realize the power that we all possess. Sometimes you need someone like a Wungan to make you dance, to bring the loi up out of you. See, the thing is, you know, you rather say, you need a samba. You need a Wungan to sing for you and a samba to beat the drums, to bring what's in you out of you. What's in you upon you. So, with that said, I conclude this video. Thank you guys for watching. Like, share, and subscribe.